Barrett, you have 5 minutes, Deputy.
Taoiseach, the German-European Affairs Minister, when he was in Dublin, confirmed that you and your government conspired with our so-called European partners to try and avoid a referendum and deny the people of this country a right to have a say on this treaty that is going to have such far-reaching effects. The Constitution has saved democracy and saved the rights of citizens in this country to allow them to have a say, despite your conspiring and manoeuvring with our so-called European partners. And it says everything about the austerity agenda being pursued by Europe and the thrust of this treaty, which is just the latest instalment in the austerity agenda, that we have already seen two elected prime ministers deposed in order to ram through the policy of bailing out banks and inflicting austerity on the citizens of Europe, and that you then also conspired with our European partners to try and prevent a referendum here. However, thankfully, the Constitution has ensured that the people will have their say. And so we need to discuss the substance of this treaty. And the substance is very simple. It seeks to deny democratically elected governments the right to borrow virtually at all. And to do that at any time, to deny the right of a democratically elected government to borrow money to invest in jobs, in infrastructure, in industrial development, in economic and social development is madness. It's anti-democratic and it is economically stupid. But to do it at a time of recession is absolutely crazy. And the evidence is clear everywhere. And it's not just the left who are saying this. Mainstream economists, very prominent economists right across the world are saying, especially in times of recession, you need the flexibility to be able to borrow, to invest in your economy, to provide stimulus. This treaty denies us the right to do it. And the evidence of what this policy is resulting in is everywhere across Europe, most dramatically in Greece. Greece is in trouble, not because they resisted the austerity agenda, or the people resisted it, but because the government capitulated to the austerity agenda. And the result has been catastrophic for the people of Greece and for its economy, which has collapsed under the impact of the austerity agenda. And those same consequences are now becoming clear here, with all the downgrading of growth forecasts for this economy and now for the entire European economy. Austerity is suffocating our economy and the European economy and choking off any possibility of economic growth and development. But the supreme irony and hypocrisy of this treaty is this. On the one hand, the treaty says you cannot borrow to invest in jobs, in industrial development, in economic and social development, in infrastructural development, but at the same time, the same people who are demanding this are saying you must borrow tens of billions to pay off the gambling debts of casino banks and financial institutions. So it's one law for the people, for their future, for their jobs, for the prospects of economic growth, but it is another law for the banks and the financial institutions. We must borrow at a desperate cost to this country in order to pay off the bankers and speculators, but under no circumstances will we be allowed to borrow in order to fund job creation or economic and industrial development, precisely the things that offer us some way out of this crisis. So I will be, there's no point in appealing to you, but we will be appealing very, very strongly to the people of this country to say no to this austerity agenda and to fight for a different type of Europe, not in or out of Europe, but for a social Europe and a Europe with an economic future.
Thank you, Deputy Ross.
Thanks, Gangula.